could happen overnight. Quickly now, in the time we've got left, a question. Does Dr. Paul foresee a default on U.S. debt, a bank holiday, and a quick devaluation of the UDS, much like happened in Argentina in early 2000? We already see they're having to monetize quite a lot of the debt, the government buying its own debt.
Well, I don't think it's going to be one of these things. In the old days, they had deliberate announcements and devaluations. The dollar's being devalued every single day. So that's going to happen. But there will be a time when the psychology changes, when it will turn into a rout, and that's what they can't control. And, of course, if they're in the control of the government and the power and the army and everything else, then they end up picking up all the pieces. But I don't think there'll be a bank holiday. I mean, that would help cause the panic that people then would really, really run out of the currency. So they're not going to close down the banks. They're going to keep the presses running. They don't default by not paying the bills. They're always going to pay Social Security. They're always going to pay.
They default by inflating. They default by.
If they can inflate 50%, they've just defaulted on half of the debt. And that's
okay, Congressman.
Liquidate that.
In the limited time, more and more, it looks to me like Obama's going to be a one-term president. I mean, he's got a record drop in polls for a president 7 months into office. Your take on Obama's political fortunes? He promised the moon. He's delivering none of it. What do you see happening?
I don't think he'll be reelected, but I think it's way too early to know that for sure. But his circumstances are much more difficult. And I often thought about this early on, whether he would be like Roosevelt and never get blamed for anything. Roosevelt got more popular and kept getting reelected in spite of the fact that he really prolonged the Depression.
Yeah, I don't think he's following the Roosevelt pattern, do you?
Yeah, no, I think you're right on that. I think Obama is going to receive some of the blame, and rightfully so. Not that he created the monster. You know, the monster was there already.
But he certainly works for the same people. Congressman, next, 2012, it's a lot closer than it was. We're talking 2 years away from the campaign starting up. Ron Paul going to be running for president 2012?
Which country?
The United States. You know you have to run to educate people again, and now they're really going to be listening to you. Ron Paul, you running for 2012?
I have no plans for that. I wouldn't be able to make a decision on that today. I mean, that's a long way off.
But we know you're going to do it, and I'll be supporting you. Hey, what about your son? Another chip off the old block, medical doctor, Rand Paul. Looks like he can win in Kentucky. Looks like he's going to be running.
It sure does. He's making some announcements today and tomorrow. So I think it's going to be explicit. His one contention was he didn't want to take on an incumbent, you know, Bunning. Bunning is not the most popular guy, but he did do a pretty good job on the Federal Reserve and some other issues, and he didn't want to run against him. He didn't think it was smart. But Bunning is out, and now the big question is can Rand compete, you know, with Grayson, who's the establishment candidate? And that'll be a test on our supporters around the country, whether or not they'll send them enough money to run a good race.
And fire out the Campaign for Liberty, Rand's site. Give us some of the sites, Doctor, we should visit.
Well, Campaign for Liberty is our main site, and that's one to go. And I don't know precisely, but I'm sure Rand Paul for the Senate would find you something for his website. But we would welcome any support we can get.
Absolutely. We were going to have him back on in the next few days and again next week. And we've got his site up on screen. Also, campaignforliberty.com is up on screen. The barbecue is coming up in Texas. Find out more at Campaign for Liberty on that. In closing.
Okay, go ahead.
No, go ahead about the barbecue.
No, that would have to be Ron Paul for Congress, re-elect for Congress, because Campaign for Liberty, this is going to be a political event. We're hoping to have a real nice event because it is in the district and it's in Galveston, and they got slaughtered, you know, with the hurricane. So we're trying to, perk the business community up a little bit there.
In closing, we got about 45 seconds. Holdren's book calling for putting sterilants in the water, having the CPS take all children at birth, and just total scientific dictatorship. Does it concern you that the White House science czar wrote a textbook on how to carry out world government?
Sure it does, but that stuff's been around. I'm just glad people are bringing it to the surface.
Would you call for an investigation into Holdren for these ideas?
I would call for an investigation of the whole government all the time, because there's too much government. It's too secret. So the more we find out about any of their shenanigans, the better.
Congressman Ron Paul, have a great recess.
All right.
God bless you.
Very good. Thanks.
Thank you so much. We'll be right back.